I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making loaded whipped potatoes. And the background behind this is that we recently went on a field trip, Rick and I, and we had lunch at Malone's restaurant in Lexington. And one of the things that I had was a loaded baked potato. And I didn't necessarily have to make that when I came back. I wanted to make something, or at least mention Malone's again, because we did enjoy our visit and we do thank Malone's for their hospitality. But I decided we'd do kind of a twist on the loaded baked potato, and instead of having baked potatoes, we would do whipped potatoes. And I would put all of the same fillers inside, and we would have all those luscious flavors of cheddar cheese and sour cream and bacon and green onions. But we would have something that you could serve from a spoon at a table of five or six, maybe, instead of having individual portions. So that's the history behind my choice. And I want to show you what kind of potato I'm using. It's a baking potato, and this is a russet variety. You don't have to use this particular type of potato, but try to pick one that bakes very well, because it will be nice and mealy and it will be proper for this treatment. Now we're going to boil these. I have two potatoes that were about this size, actually a little bit bigger, that I peeled and then I chopped into cubes. I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. These are just in a pan that I have kept covered with water until we got ready to start, and then I drained the water off, so there's nothing else in there except now there is 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 2 tablespoons of butter. You can double this recipe if you want to. You could have 4 potatoes that you have peeled and chopped up, and then just double everything else. But we want our milk to come up the edges until you can see it. There'll be a few potatoes that are up above the line of the milk, and then the rest of them are below. What we're going to do is bring this to a boil, and I'll stir it around because that butter will melt and I want it distributed. I'll watch it, tend it for a while, and once it boils, I will put this lid on, and then I'll check it occasionally. It doesn't take long when you have cubes like this. These were maybe 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch cubes, so probably about 12 to 15 minutes, but I'll use a fork, and if they are crumbly, then I know that they are done, and I will keep track of that because there'll be a point where they're a little bit tender, but if you try to do anything with them, they would be lumpy. So I want them to get all the way done. My potato cubes have cooked for 15 minutes since they came to a boil. It took about 5 minutes to get them to a boil. And I've been checking them, and you can see that at this point, they are very tender. And you don't really want to let them go longer than that, but you want to get them to the point where they can be pierced with a fork very easily, and they're very soft. So I'm going to drain these through a colander, but I'm going to save the milk because that's going to be the milk I use in whipping the potatoes. So here we are with our cooked cubed potatoes, and here is the milk that it is boiled down to. I don't know how much I actually added because I was just pouring to get a certain level. And it's okay for it to be a little bit low because it is going to bubble up and you don't want it to boil over. So you can adjust that to whatever seems to suit you. You can see the potatoes are ready to be whipped. They're nice and soft, but I am going to add some salt. I'm going to grind in some salt, and this will be to taste. Actually, what I want to do is take a little taste of the potatoes where I didn't salt them and see how much salt they picked up from the cooking, because we did salt that milk. Very mildly salted. So I would add a little bit, and I would keep testing. I don't like to add a whole lot because if you overdo it, you can't take it out. Here we have 2 tablespoons of butter. And these are already a little bit buttery because we put butter in that milk, and we're going to be using that buttered milk. as we continue to beat these. Now I'm going to beat these, and when they get to the point where they need to be softened up, I'll be adding just as much of that milk as I need. Here's what the potatoes look like when I've whipped just the potatoes, the butter, and a little bit of salt. So we're going to pour in some of this milk. It started out as 1 1/2 cups, I noticed here, after it came off the stove. But we'll start with a little bit, and then we'll just add as much as we need to get a nice texture, and I'll show that to you in just a minute. I've used all but 1/2 cup of the milk, and I think these are just fine. I like the texture really well, and we are going to add some other things to this, so I'm accounting for that as well. At this point, we go to a spatula so we can fold in our next ingredient. I'm through with the mixing process, and I'm just going to be folding or maybe decorating the top. I have sour cream. I'm putting in 1/2 cup. And this I am going to fold fairly gently, and then I want to grind some peppercorns. Not too many. You can really overdo this until you don't care for it that much, but a little bit really helps the flavor. And fold that in. The next thing that I'm folding is cheddar cheese. This is finely shredded cheddar cheese, 1/2 cup. And then I'm going to put it out on in a bowl or on a serving dish. I've decided on kind of a flat platter here. And then I'll put some toppings on. So this is loaded in a way that it's topped a little bit, but most of it is actually in the whipped potatoes. In finalizing it, I have set aside 1/2 cup of green onion tops, and they are cut in about 3/8 inch size pieces. And we don't want to really fold those in. You could, but then they will taste cooked. And I think we want them crunchy and raw. So just put as many of those on top as you would like. And then the last thing I'm putting on is the thing that is most important to be crisp, and that is bacon. And I've got 3 slices of bacon that I've already cooked, and then I crisp them up in the microwave and I have crumbled them. So I really love this part. So we've transformed our loaded baked potato into loaded whipped potatoes, and I think you'll enjoy this version of potatoes with all those wonderful flavors in it. I'm going to take a taste for you. I just can't decide where to start. Over here we've got some bacon and we've got some green onion. I see some yellow cheddar cheese. Looks like a good bite. I love all these flavors, and together they're just perfect. Also, it's an easy way for you to make 2 potatoes look like a lot. And you can serve this on a table where you have guests, and 4 people could share in that and still feel like they have plenty of potatoes because of all the other things that went in with it. I think you'll enjoy the recipe. I certainly hope so.